Donnette Norman is a teacher at the Woodrose Girls School. She is a graduate of the Bible University College, the University of Technology, the Jamaica Theological Seminary, where she gained a Bachelor of Arts degree in General Studies with emphasis in guidance and counseling and Christian education. Donnette also earned a master's degree in education administration at the University of the West Indies, Mona. Her Christian upbringing has its roots in the Church of God of Prophecy, where she obtained invaluable experience in youth leadership and ministry. She is a motivational speaker, a guidance counselor, marriage officer, and an ordained minister at the Bible's Teacher International, where she currently serves as a Caribbean director of schools. She currently serves as a member of the National SCFSU ISCF Board. She is also a part-time lecturer at the Jamaica Theological Seminary. Donnette is the founder and president of the Christian Youth Leaders Training and Mentoring Program and Christian Teacher
17 major high school conferences. We have written about 19 books. And by the way, passion really is not just for young people, it's for the young at heart. So you will find on our book table books for every member of the family. I'm particularly recommending The Real Men and Healing Love, and I'm recommending Word Vibes. Word Vibes, if you don't have enough this morning, order through your pastor's wife and you will drop them off. stand up in your house. And I pray God, some of you are going to hell at home within the pandemic, but guess what? God has allowed you to be born in the family that you were born in. It's not by mistake. He has set the boundaries of your habitation so that you may feel after him. God designed the country you would be born in, the family you would be born in, where you would be living in the pandemic, who would be in the house, and if you have the Holy Ghost, he is relying on that river of living water to flow out to the members around you. And so that is why you will always be coming with the teachings on love, on forgiveness. Because guess what? This is the time when some of those family members that you have been praying about, God is going to allow them to treat you so bad. Because there is a love that is on the inside of you. Saints of God, some of you have done those courses, but let me just tell you this. There are lots of things that we're asking God for that he gave us as salvation. He already gave them to you. We're asking him for the mind of Christ. When you were born again, you were made perfect in him. God's works are perfect. If you are born again, none of God's children have any birth defects. You were created perfect in him. He installed his divine nature inside of you. He gave you the mind of Christ. He made you pure and holy when you were born again. And by the way, the word of God is coming now on your born again children that will be born in this revival, that will go through their lives
If you are a lustful, if you are a child, if you are a patient, love and peace. When are you going to send brother? When are you going to send sister right? God wants you to wait like a waiter with your hands full, consecrated unto him. Now is the time for you to take up ministry. You see the people that you have never done before. I can speak to you. At 12 years old, I was teaching Sunday school. At 18 years old, I was a youth pastor for 5 churches. And the main church had over 125 young people. A lot of them are ministers today. And by the way, guess what? I had my hands so full of God, I didn't have any time to be distracted. I said, God, this feels so good. I was traveling around Jamaica preaching revivals. I was just having my hands full. And he read about me in a church magazine, an international church magazine, and a local church magazine. And he was just reading about some lady and said, God, I just admire the passion of Jesus Christ in her. So I went to the National Arena for a convention. And I went way up in upstairs because I didn't want anybody to distract me. I wanted to hear what God was saying. And he was Sunday school prior secretary for 24 churches in Portland. He was a youth director. He was on fire for God. And he came on the bus with his young people and he said, I don't want nobody to distract me. I'm going upstairs to hear what God is saying to the Lord. And 4 years after that, the Lord told him I was his wife. What am I saying, single people? Get your hands consecrated. Get your hearts full of the love of God. Hallelujah. Right now we marry a lot of the young people too passionately. Church. God is and one flesh. In the world, any two flesh can marry, and they can live happily ever after. But if they don't get saved, they're not going to heaven. But when it comes down to the people of God, you must be one in spirit and one in flesh. That means, and it takes a dedication to get there. There are times when the Holy Spirit will say, it's time to pray for, and both of us, it says the same thing. Why? Because we are one in spirit and one flesh. Now, some of you have gotten married already, and you are married to people who are unsaved, right? You will have a right. You will have to use a meek and quiet spirit to win that man to God. Unfortunately, we have too many religious wives in the church who spend more time concerned about the things of the church and ignore their children and their husbands who have become bitter against them because they don't feel that love at home. Some of you need to leave here today and apologize to your husband because they have just not seen the character of Christ. And maybe if you show the character of Christ, that man will begin to hear. And by the way, I'm not telling you something that I haven't walked, I haven't seen. There are times in the mind when somebody has to humble themselves. Somebody wants to humble themselves in that situation in both of your Christians. I know three ladies who bore with their husband. Husband was humanizing, drinking, until one day, one of them was a pastor. She was preaching one night and giving an altar call. She heard a commotion. Guess what? It was the Holy Ghost who brought her husband to the altar. When he got saved, the scales of his eyes came off. But Gaze, he kept telling her, and Some money you need to pay them back. Hallelujah.
people.